Where's that prescription you filled for me?
I put it in here. Is this my toothbrush?
It's Rex's, covered in his DNA.
And you want me to have this? Why?
Your son? I know he's not Brody's. But with this, he can be. Oh, there it is. Hope it helps.
If you were just going out for eggs, why did you have my toothbrush with you? Adriana, you and I were talking, and I set this on the counter before I went to take a shower. I just want to know why you had it with you. And why it was in a plastic bag like you were taking it for a lab test. Ever see a walk-off home run before?
Yeah, a couple of times.
Shane? What do you think you're doing?
Mom, what's wrong?
What's wrong? You were just about to pick up that bottle of beer.
It's a big deal.
That is it, Brody. You are out of here now.
David, you're so good at this. Amazingly supple and nimble.
Well, you know what they say, practice, practice, practice. To tell you the truth, I've always found the Eastern techniques very liberating.
Oh my God. Mama?
Namaste, Blair.
What happened? He's been lying to me for months. He's been lying about his son. I'm so sorry, Mom. Well, honey, you didn't have anything to do with it.
No, actually, I did.
You knew he was lying about being Rex's father?
Is that all he told you?
So far, yes. He said we have to talk more. Well, maybe you should tell me everything you know about Charlie.
It's over, Dorian. No more secrets. Okay, you're just going to have to find some other way to torture what few friends you have left in your life. And now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to call Vicky and tell her that I'm heading home.
No, Charlie. Would you not
call... Dorian!
Vicky! Charlie, don't.
Dorian, what the hell are you doing?
Just relax. Just relax.
Sorry.
Lay back.
Dorian.
Hey. I'm so sorry, Charlie. But you see, I couldn't have you telling Vicky or Rex that Jared is really your son and not Buchanan. We're just going to have to save that tidbit of news. Until I do what I have to do.
You mean my son?
No.
Did you just say no?
That is exactly what I said, Todd. You don't deserve him. You never deserved him.
Give him back to me or I'm going to tear you apart, Mike.
Hey, you are not going to lay a finger on her, all right?
Take it easy. Take it easy, Mike, all right? Someone want to tell me what's going on here?
Yes, I would. He tried to kill my son tonight.
You know, I should have put you in jail when I had the chance. I won't make the same mistake again, I'll tell you that.
You know what? You could have killed Sam in that wreck tonight, and now you're going to come in here and make threats, make demands?
So he is my son, and Mercy knows that.
The only thing I know, John, is that Todd had this child in the front seat of his car when he got into an accident, and he didn't even have him in a car seat.
Oh, really? No, that's a lie. Dorian's idiot daughter ran into me, and these two nut jobs were sitting in Angel Square about 10 feet away from the accident. They probably set the whole thing up, trying to make me look reckless.
Oh, shut up. You're lying. You're always lying. You're unconscious when I got to the car, and I found Tommy in the front seat. Would you like to tell him the law? Infants and toddlers have to be in a car seat, in the back seat of the car.
She's got you there, man.
No, she's got nothing. There was a car seat in the back seat of the car, and that's where Sam was.
You think you can just say it? And everyone is going to believe you. You know, I swear, John, he is lying. Tommy was in the front seat of the car, and we're lucky he wasn't killed. Okay, David, get your hands off of my mother.
Technically, it's the other way around.
It's one of our favorite positions.
Mother, listen. You just have to make this go away, please.
No. Very good, Mama. And relax. The chi in this room was incredible.
Thank you.
I hope we can do it again soon.
You can count on it.
Mama, have you completely stopped taking your medication? Didn't you hear what she just said about my chi?
Our chi. It's collective.
And what are you doing here in this house, David? Dressed like that, doing partner yoga with my mother?
It's Dorian's house. She invited me.
Well, you know what? I'm going to have a conversation with her about it.
Don't say anything bad about David. I like having him here.
Mama, it's just not the right time to have a house guest.
Okay? Why not? We have plenty of
room.
Well,
because I bought Star Home, and I had to change the locks to keep Todd out.
You're having problems with Todd?
But out.
Blair!
Mama, look, they're teenagers in this house. They're normal people in this house.
I haven't...
No, but we just need our lives to be private.
I haven't said one word to David about Star.
What's going on with Star, Blair?
Come in. Oh, you okay?
Yeah, I'm glad to be home.
You are?
Well, I'm excited to be sleeping in my own bed tonight. I'm just really gonna miss being next to Cole, that's all.
So, you and Cole slept together while you were away?
Well, we slept in the same bed, but we didn't.
You didn't have sex?
No, it wasn't about that, okay? Plus, I wasn't feeling all too good most of the time.
Well, are you feeling better now?
Yeah, except for the going out of my mind part.
What do you mean?
Do you think I'm crazy to think that I might be able to have this baby and raise it?
Mom, chill out. I've like maybe 3 sips of beer.
It's not like I'm drunk or anything. It's not a big deal.
I think maybe it's a big deal.
You are 10 years old, Shane.
My sister used to let her 3-year-old take nips off her beer.
Your sister and her kid are both morons.
I'm sorry if I broke some kind of house rule or something, but he really didn't drink that much. He just was holding the bottle.
He is not your drinking buddy, Brody. He is a child.
I'm not a baby.
Your part of this conversation is over.
I don't understand why you're flying off the handle.
I know you don't, which is exactly why I want you out of here now.
Dad just found us. You can't kick him out.
Oh, I can, and I will. I'll do whatever it takes to protect you.
I hate you. You always ruin everything.
Shane Marasco, you get down here!
That went well.
Do you think this is funny?
I think you need to take it down a couple notches.
I think you need to tell me what the hell you're trying to do in my life.
Maybe make it a little better?
By giving my 10-year-old beer?
Shane thinks I'm his dad. Okay, dads and sons, they watch the game together. They have a couple beers.
They don't drink beer together when the kid is 10, unless the dad is a lunatic. Not good dads or real dads. And you are not Shane's dad.
I never told him I was. You did.
Okay, you're right. I was going to take your toothbrush to get a lab test.
For what?
Well, after you were talking about wanting to check Charlie's DNA to make sure that he was really your father.
But decided I didn't need to.
I know, but you didn't seem like you were 100% sure, so I figured I would just do the test myself and put your mind at ease.
To make sure Charlie's my father.
Yeah.
But to do that, you would have needed this. It's got Charlie's DNA all over it, and it was sitting right here on the counter. If you wanted to prove that Charlie was my father, why would you take my toothbrush and not this fork?
And you better bring a friend, because the package to be delivered is quite heavy. No, meet me at the back entrance of Landview Hospital. Fine. 15 minutes. That's right, Charlie. Just keep sleeping. Relax. Dr. Lord is going to take care of you.
I don't care if I was the one who told Shane you were his father. That doesn't give you an excuse to sit here and teach a 10-year-old the joys of alcohol.
All right, maybe letting the kid sip a beer was a mistake. I'm just trying to be the guy Shane thinks I am. I want him to trust me.
Trust you. Did you bother to read any of this to Shane? You're a superhero. You're a god. He doesn't need beer to trust you.
I read every word of this, and this guy isn't real. He sure as hell isn't me. I was trying to show Shane someone who's real.
So you thought by giving him beer, that would make you cool in his eyes.
Gigi. I learned a lot of things when I was in the service, okay? I learned how to rig explosives, how to swim 3 miles with a 25-pound pack on my back, how to kill a guy with my bare hands. But I didn't learn a damn thing about how to be a father. So why don't you tell me, Mom? Why don't you tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it?
Rex, why are you doing this? I was just in an accident. I could have been hurt, and you're grilling me like I'm some case you're working on.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be grilling you. It just doesn't make sense.
Oh,
you...
God.
Whoa, what's wrong? What's wrong?
I don't feel so good.
Okay.
I think just the painkillers. Maybe it's just too...
Oh, okay.
Oh, the room is spinning.
All right. Hang on. Well, this is all starting to make sense now.
What makes sense?
That day when I came upon you grilling Charlie, asking him why he didn't get any mail and where he had lived before. It's all because you knew that Rex wasn't his son?
No, I didn't know then.
Well, when did you know? Did Roxy tell you?
No, she didn't, although I know Roxy well enough to know when she's lying.
So you knew she was lying about Rex?
I suspected it.
Is this not something you felt you could share with me?
Mom, I knew how happy you were with Charlie, okay? I just didn't want you to get hurt.
I trusted him. Completely. And he lied to me.
Well, maybe he had a good reason.
For lying?
Yeah. I mean, you know, you once told me that you would do anything for your children.
But Rex is not Charlie's son.
Hey! This little girl is not going to go to bed early tonight, so we thought that she would do well with a visit with Grandma.
Ooh.
Hey, sweetie. Where's Nash? Oh, he has some business dinner vineyard thing, so...
My goodness. Well, aren't I a lucky one? I get to see her tonight and tomorrow.
Yeah, she's going to be two already, huh?
Amazing. Absolutely amazing.
Oh,
my goodness. Have you decided to be terrible and say no?
Oh, she's been doing that for a while already.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Goodness.
Do you got some plans or something? Or?
No. No, absolutely no plans. In fact, this little girl is exactly who I needed to see right now.
No, I don't think you're crazy.
Yeah, but the house that we live in isn't exactly a stable environment. Okay, but your mom, your grandma, Dorian and I, we're all gonna pitch in and help. I mean, that baby's gonna have more love than any other baby in the world.
Okay, just stop with all of the Kramer stuff. Really, it gets old.
What's wrong? I mean, what else is wrong?
It's when Cole and I ran away.
I know. You must have been so scared.
Well, I was, but at the same time, I mean, the place that we stayed in, it was really crappy. But Cole brought me flowers to make it nicer. That's so sweet. I know, he did everything he possibly could to make sure that I was as happy and comfortable as I could be. And he said that we would just get enough money so that we can get our own little place.
Sounds almost perfect.
Almost.
You got homesick?
Yeah. But some of the time, but then the other time I just felt free, you know, because for so long I'd been so mad at my dad and
afraid of him.
You should have seen his face on the boardwalk when he grabbed me.
You must have been so scared when you woke up in the hospital.
You know what? The second I saw my mom, and I gave her a big hug, I just wanted her to hold on to me forever.
Not that it's any of your business, David, but
I just brought my daughter home. She ran away.
Oh, that must make you feel like a failure as a mother.
It makes me feel that I don't want to see my daughter see you in those clothes doing yoga naked with my mother.
I wasn't naked.
No, I just don't want to think of you being naked doing anything around here, okay?
Yeah, well, good luck with that.
Okay, don't you unpack, David, because I am going to have a conversation with Dorian about the situation.
Sounds like somebody woke up on the wrong side of the crypt this morning.
Mama, nobody is supposed to know about Star being pregnant. You have to be careful.
I know. I have to count to three every time I open, before I open my big mouth.
Mama, what were you thinking? Doing partner's yoga with David?
As you can plainly see, he's very well proportioned.
I give up.
Give up! Maybe that's your problem.
Martha, you gotta give him back.
No. Michael, he could have died.
I know. And we'll look into pressing charges.
Nothing to look into. Give him. Let's go. It's okay.
All right. Hold on a minute there, Manny.
Excuse after me. I need some help with the body inside.
Yes, doctor.
Grazie. Thank you. Go.
What now, John?
Well, you're wrong. Marcy, there was a car seat in the back of Manning's car.
No, there wasn't, John, I swear.
I told you she's nuts.
Yeah. Problem is, when the LPD showed up to tow the car, there was a guy in the backseat of your car trying to strap the car seat into the car.
Really? He's probably trying to steal it.
Nah, because the LPD, when they were doing the accident report, had already reported there was no car seat in the back of the car.
You're unbelievable.
The whole thing's a setup.
No, you know what the whole thing is? It's a really bad sham on your part. And next time you hire one of your flunkies to try to do your dirty work, try to hire one that won't roll over on you in two questions.
You know, when I first saw my mom in the hospital, I just, for some strange reason, I just wanted to be at the kitchen table doing my homework and her cooking me dinner, you know? Even though she doesn't really cook dinner that often.
You know. So, was it hard telling her?
Yeah, but she didn't judge me. She didn't ask me a million questions. She just took control and made sure that I was okay. Made sure that my dad wouldn't hurt me or Cole.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it really was.
So, what was it like when your dad showed up here?
Well, I mean, my mom got in a huge fight, and my dad refused to leave without Sam. I mean, everybody's really afraid of my dad right now. If he found out that I'm pregnant, I really don't know what he would do.
I don't have to listen to this garbage.
You're not walking out of here with the kid. He had him in the front seat of the car without the car seat when the accident happened.
So now you're the judge, and I suppose these two chatterheads are the jury, eh? Okay. Now, call these goons off, man.
How were you planning to take him home? You didn't have a car seat for him. You don't have a car, so you still aren't thinking about his safety, are you? You only think about yourself.
Sometimes I think about how you kept him from me for 2 years of his life.
About you, Manning.
You can't arrest me for this.
Child Protective Services will determine whether you walk out of here with your son tonight. Till they show up, you're not going anywhere.
I'm sorry, but the only reason I told Shane you were his father is because I thought you were dead.
I'm sorry to disappoint you.
Oh, that's not fair, Brody. I can't tell you how happy I am that you didn't die.
Well, somehow I'm not getting that feeling.
Because I'm mad right now. I'm mad. You've given me every reason to be. That doesn't mean I'm not thankful you're alive.
You were a lifesaver for me 10 years ago. I was pregnant by another man and in love with him, and you didn't care. You wanted to take care of me anyway. You made me feel like I was worth something.
You were. You are.
Thank you for saying that.
So the only reason you told Shane I was his dad was because you thought I was dead?
And because I figured that I would be proud if he grew up to be the Brody that I knew back then. The gentle, brave man who was willing to come to my rescue.
I'm not sure what happened to that guy.
Well, if you really came here to try and help me now, like you said, then you're going to have to follow some rules, or you can't stay here another night.
I understand.
Thank you. Look how mad I got.
I don't think your kid could believe it either.
Yeah, well, maybe it's time his father had a talk with him then.
Hello?
Rex, hi, it's Vicki Davidson. I'm sorry for calling so late.
No problem. Is everything okay?
Yes. I was just wondering if you'd heard from Charlie this evening?
Not since we left the hospital.
The hospital? Why? What happened?
Charlie was here, and Adriana called and said that she had been in an accident.
Good Lord, is she all right?
Oh, she hurt her knee, but she's fine. But I didn't know that, so Charlie went to the hospital with me.
I see. And you haven't heard from Charlie since you left the hospital?
No. Something wrong, Vicki?
No. No, nothing's wrong.
Upstairs. I told you where my room is, all right?
Dorian? Do you want to tell me what you think you're doing?
I know it looks shameful, but I can explain.
Okay, you know, it's bad enough that I have to come home and find this living here. But you know how I discovered? He was in that room, on a mat, practically naked with my mother doing yoga.
You were practically naked with Addie?
Define practically.
I want you to assure me and Blair that that will never happen again.
Dorian, what's important here is I think it's just bad timing to have somebody here living with us. You know, I think the timing stinks.
I think that life is all about learning how to deal with things that you can't control, like bad timing.
That's very nice. That's always been our story, hasn't it?
Okay, Dorian, this is your house.
But David, if I see your butt or even your practically naked butt anywhere in this house, I'm going to kick it all the way to Philadelphia. You got it?
Blair, you are a married woman. I will not show you my naked butt.
Oh. Where are you going?
Hi.
I'm going to see my daughter. Is that all right with you,
please? Of course. Go right ahead.
Okay.
Start?
Feeling all right?
Yeah, actually, I was just talking to Langston about how glad I am to be home.
Oh, I'm glad. Ooh. That's your dad. I'll have to take it. That's how, what do you want?
Blair, if you ever cared about me at all, if you'll help me right now.
Vicky, you worried about Charlie?
No. No, I'm just trying to track him down, that's all. Give Adriana my love, okay? And, good night.
Good night.
What was that about?
Oh, I'm not sure. You feeling any better?
Yeah, just a little queasy. Probably just need to get some sleep.
Good idea.
Was lying when he said he was Rex's father. I don't believe it. Why would you do that? Why would you do that to Rex?
I don't know. He said it had something to do with helping Roxy cover something up. Frankly, I don't get that at all.
So Rex doesn't know yet?
No, I'm quite sure he doesn't know.
Well, if Charlie isn't with Rex, where is he?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Well, I think you should call him. I think you should get to the bottom of this now.
Why did you come down? I told you to wait until I gave you the all clear.
The guy's phone's buzzing.
Oh.
Vicky.
I was way out of line tonight letting you drink that beer. And when I got in your mom's face about it, that was even worse.
Are you just saying this because my mom made you?
No. I'm saying it because it's the truth. Now it's time for you to say something. To your mother.
What?
You're a smart kid, Shane. You know what needs to be said. What happened tonight was my fault. But you mouthed off at your mother when she got upset. You've had an incredible mother your whole life. She's worked hard to take good care of you. And I bet she never griped about it either. Because she loves you more than anything in the world.
I know. I'm sorry I said what I did, Mom.
I'm sorry I lost my temper and yelled at you the way I did.
It's okay. I guess I kind of deserved it. Are you still mad at me?
Have I ever been able to stay mad at you?
Are you still mad at Ted?
I think Brody and I understand each other now. Mom is so upset.
Yeah, she's upset. She has every right to be upset. Charlie lied to her.
Yeah, I know. You know, I really hope that they work things out because she was really happy with him and she deserves to be happy.
Natalie. She deserves somebody honest and caring, and it's obviously not Charlie.
Okay. I think it's time that we started singing happy birthday lots and lots of times.
Yeah, that'll cheer Grandma up, huh?
I have to tell you that you three, and Kevin and Joey, are the most important people in my life. And I hope that you will always know that.
chance. Did you get a hold of Charlie or leave him a message?
No. If Charlie wants to talk to me, Charlie can call me.
Charlie.
You're in.
David, I do not want you to ever agitate Blair or Addie or me again.
Well, I tell you what. If you allow me to stay here, I will agree to that on one condition. You tell me what those questionable gentlemen were doing here earlier. And whose phone is that?
Mine.
You wouldn't be caught dead with last season's model.
David, keep your mouth shut, and you will get a lot of money in return. Have you got it?
My lips are sealed. I wouldn't call if I didn't need your help.
Was Sam all right?
He's fine, but...
Okay, you know what? Then you take care of him. Don't put him in danger just like you did your daughter, all right? Goodbye.
What did he want?
You know, I don't care. Just as long as Sam's okay, it doesn't matter to me.
I miss him already.
I'm talking about Sam, okay? I'm not talking about Dad. I don't miss him at all.
Hey, sorry to get you down here so late, Yolanda.
Proud of the job.
Okay.
Is this Tommy? He's grown.
His name's Sam.
Nice to see you again, Mr. Manning.
Now, you know that this child belongs with me. I have legal custody over him. I don't know. You're probably in league with these guys. I don't know what kind of
situation. It's my understanding you were in an accident because you're on your cell phone while driving with this child in the front seat of the car without a car seat. Is that accurate? By authority of the state of Pennsylvania, I will be taking this child into protective custody for 24 hours, pending a hearing in court.
Is this what you want? Put Sam back in the system like this?
He almost killed him. Is that what you wanted?
I'll take the child into custody now.
You heard her, Manny.
This is the sound of the planes in the night, coming out of the darkness and into the light, shining alarmingly, curiously bright. This is the sound of those murderous drums, the marching of footsteps, the twisting.
Yeah.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next One Life to Live.
On the next One Life to Live.
Who is it? Is it the Phobe Buchanan? Is that who's been sleeping in your bed?
Dorian? Can I come in, please?
The police found out that Sam was in the front without a car seat, and I have to go testify.
Watch weekdays on ABC, weeknights on Soap.